that there is an alkene group, because why would they talk about cis trans isomerism if it wasn't for an alkene? Because we know that only alkenes can show cis trans isomerism, and we also know that in an alkene, if identical groups are attached to one of the carbon atoms, then it will not show cis trans isomerism in that case. So what this tells us is that there is a carbon-carbon double bond, and this carbon-carbon double bond is terminal, which means it is at the end because it is not showing cis trans isomerism. So this is what we have deduced. Now, when compound U is heated under reflux, in the presence of excess acidified potassium dichromate, the organic product gives the infrared spectrum shown. So this is the infrared spectrum of the product. Now, the first thing we need to realize is that this is not the infrared spectrum of U. It is the infrared spectrum of the product from this reaction. Now, if you notice, heating under reflux, excess acidified potassium dichromate, this has to be an oxidation reaction, because these conditions are used for oxidation. Now, what do we know about oxidation? There is a single oxygen atom, which means it can be an alcohol or an aldehyde. And if it's an alcohol, it can be a primary alcohol or a secondary alcohol. So if it's a primary alcohol or an aldehyde, then it oxidizes to a carboxylic acid. If it's a secondary alcohol, then it oxidizes to a ketone. So by looking at the infrared spectrum of the product, we will first have to deduce if it's oxidizing to a carboxylic acid or a ketone. And based on that, we'll be able to tell whether it's an aldehyde or an alcohol, and specifically a primary alcohol or a secondary alcohol. So let's move forward now. So let's gather all the information. Before we look at the spectrum, let's gather all the information we have about compound U. So we know that compound U contains a chiral center. This is the first point. The second point is we know that U contains a carbon-carbon double bond. So this is the second point. The third point is that the carbon-carbon double bond must be terminal because it's not showing cis trans isomerism. And the fourth point is that the oxygen can either be an oxygen of a primary alcohol, a secondary alcohol, or an aldehyde. So there are three things that can be possible for that oxygen. Now, let's delve into the infrared spectrum of the oxidation product of U. So before doing anything else, I forgot to actually tell you something about infrared spectra, which we can do now looking at the spectrum. So at wave numbers below 1200, we have something called the fingerprint region. Fingerprint region. So what do we know about fingerprints? We know that every person has a different fingerprint, and that's why we use fingerprint scanners in our phones, for security systems and everything, because we know that if we put our fingerprint in something, only our fingerprint can open that lock, because everyone's fingerprint cannot be the same as mine. Everyone's fingerprint is different. It's a characteristic of them. It's their own unique characteristic. So just like that, this is called the fingerprint region. Let me remove the S from fingerprints. So below 1200 per centimeter, we have something called the fingerprint region. And the fingerprint region, just like the fingerprints are unique to us, it is unique to every compound. So every compound has a different fingerprint region. So we do not need to make any deductions in the fingerprint region. All we need to do is we need to know what a fingerprint region actually is. And whatever we will be doing, all the deductions we will be doing, we will be doing it in this region, which is not the fingerprint region. So we have nothing to do with the fingerprint region. You only have to know what a fingerprint region is. Whatever we will study where we will study the spectrum is the region that is apart from this fingerprint region. So it is this region that I've underlined over here, which we will be studying. Now, let's look at the peaks that just come straight to us when we see the spectrum. So there is this strong and sharp peak that comes directly to us after looking at the spectrum. And there is this strong and broad peak which comes when we look at the spectrum. So let's look at this one. Let's label these peaks 1 and 2. They will be enough to deduce the spectrum. Now, peak 1 is in the range 1600 to 1700. Now let's look at the data booklet. So 1600 to 1700 means CO. The data booklet tells me that this wave number